Previously on the Other Dungeon!
After a chance encounter at an adventurer's conference, an awkward party was formed. And after a visit to the bar, they decided to rent a room in the South Donk slums together and debated what kind of work they should do. And now, the Other Dungeon continues!
Well, the neighborhood I'm from has plenty of well-off, wealthy people, you know.
You can make some money there too, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Probably use their wealth for our advantage, to our advantage, you know.
You guys want to roll knowledge local for maybe the richest part of town or knowledge history to see who knows the richest person or
yeah.
One of those
can
two things?
Roll?
Any of you guys can roll.
I'm going to roll for. What's that mean?
Lord.
Nobility was a good one too. That would tell you who the rich people are in town. If you want to specifically a person's name.
We'll try to back you up if you fail.
I got a roll of 7.
Okay, I'll do it.
19!
Okay, but Kevin got a 19.
Well, I think there's like a geography roll or a nature roll for me. I don't know.
Did you roll something also, Eriku?
I got 17.
And what was your skill, Bakefo?
For knowledge, I have knowledge geography.
So you chose geography? And what was your choice of skill?
That's not circled. I have a plus 1 in geography.
Yeah, geography is probably your best one, so if you want to know more about geography, tell me that, and you'll get to know that'll be a better role than any of the other ones.
No, I would like that one.
Okay, so geography for you.
I have knowledge of nature.
Iriku, with the knowledge of nature, and being from this southern area, you have only been to the northern part of the city a couple of times. There's some co-ops up north where they do a lot of the farming, the animal raising, the vegetable growing, the crop growing. Just north of here, there's a very wealthy district that's sort of like east of the big forest. You know a lot about the forest. You spent a lot of time wandering the forest as a kid. So you're pretty familiar with the Donk's Forest area and the Woodlawn, as they call it, which is where a lot of the druids hang out and raise animals, and there's a zoo. So you might know that sometimes there's a lot of rich people that go to the zoo. You might find some rich tourists or rich city folk going to the zoo. That's your biggest thing with the nature role. Whereas Bakefo, with the geography, will know that the area you're in that is now called the Donks, whenever you were working on it was called District 40. And you worked on building some underground tunnels, waterways, and you worked your way up from the underground city with a lot of the other underground dwarves and gnomes, so there's an underworld here that you're familiar with. Your geography mostly tells you about that, and it tells you, you also know where the Woodlawn is. That's the area where your rock came from when the boar lived. So you know that area very well. You know the Donk's Forest, the zoo, the Woodlawn.
Roll a 5 for nobility knowledge.
Alright, so you're from the southern part of town. No wonder you got a 5. You don't know a whole lot about the nobles in town. As a matter of fact, the richest people you've ever met are the people in the room with you right now. This paladin and this fighter also are probably the two rich people you've met. 4 on what type of knowledge?
Local.
Oh, yeah. Maybe that's because you're in the southern part of town, though. You don't know a whole about local is like this local area you're in. And you don't know a whole about, you feel out of place where you're at right now. You're sort of in the slums, and you're sort of from the northern part of town. Not the nicest part of town, but a nicer part of town. You're from like the merchant district, the shipping district. So you're sort of in the bad part of town now, so you feel sort of out of place, as does Aerog.
Well, can I let them know that I know there's a wealthier, like, area north of the Donks, with the zoo?
Well, the Donks is this whole district that you guys live in. The South Donks is what the area you're called is.
I tell them all about is, and say that could be an option.
Those VIPs at the zoo? Try to snatch up on those guys?
Yeah, let's go to the zoo.
Alright, so you guys decide on your first adventure together.
Alright.
Yeah, you guys have gotten a party together, and for your first adventure, you want to go to the zoo.
Go to the zoo.
Alright, party of 4. You grab your backpacks, all your weapons, and you head down the road to the zoo. You guys will head out of your apartment, sort of northwest of here, towards the crossroads, and follow the crossroads to the Donk Zoo, sort of west. Let's see if anything happens on your way down the road. I rolled low enough that you're able to avoid the town guards. You head past the very large Donk's Forest towards the Woodlawn. There's a large plains area full of, like, druid huts. And you sort of, you see the zoo. Pretty decent-sized zoo. Menagerie full of different types of localized beasts and different animals. There's an entry fee to get in. It is 5 gold per person.
Yeah.
Do I have to pay?
Well, I'm Why don't we just, like,
for a person,
like, scope out the area around us, see who's going in.
You guys want to, like, just lurk around outside and roll a perception check? Alright. You guys can hand on the road and roll perception checks to see who's coming and going if you like. Save some money.
So
for perception is something everyone should probably roll, because then if at least one of you gets a high number, you'll know something.
Can I have the college? 19.
College is something. I got 20
in perception. 20, 19, 7.
I'm a
bore. Perception. But you have some points in it.
Oh, wait, 7 plus.
You.
I have 7, 8, 9,
10, 1.
That's
11. Oh, I have plus 1 perception, so I roll a 21.
Alright, so most of you, except the boar, are able to see.
11.
That's still not great comparatively to everyone else. It's okay. It's not bad. It's exactly what you'd expect to see from about knee height. So you're not exactly the same height as if you're not on people level. So you have a harder time picking out. You really don't. Your observation of, like, wealth and stuff are not as probably as keen as everyone else because you're not from this area or this time period. But the three of you that are from this time period in this area have a decent enough role to scope out who's coming and going. People come with their kids, mostly adults with young kids, groups of three or four from various parts of town. The zoo is not that expensive, so it does draw a lot of richer and poorer folk. I feel like anyone that rolled above a 20 will be able to spot someone dressed well enough to believe they're rich.
Yeah, I want to book out kids. Yeah, let's go.
I rolled a 21, so I should be able to pick out the richest person there.
Yeah, you should have no problem picking out someone you think is rich.
And I point him out to the guest, which is my nickname.
Yeah.
All right, so you point out the board. Do you point out to the rest of your party members as well?
Yeah.
That is a sleight of hand, so they don't notice. So roll your sleight of hand, Iriku. Okay. And then Arog and Karim can roll perception. If you guys' perception beats Iriku's sleight of hand, you see Iriku telling the boar.
I got a 2.
Yeah.
Oh, they're going to see you telling the boar, no matter, unless they roll really a 1.
I'm fine with that.
But just be cool, because I turn back and I'm like, he's nobody.
Yeah. You guys have no problem seeing this message that Iriku's trying to tell the boar. You hear everything that Iriku says. You now know that Iriku's putting out a rich person to the boar. You guys will also see this rich person. There are two of them. It is a rich couple.
Oh. Can I detect? See how bad they are?
One is evil, one is good.
Oh. Who's the good one? No, wait. I'm able to tell which is evil, though, right?
It takes you another 6 seconds, but then you are. The woman is good and the man is evil.
We're committing identity theft, that's the deal.
Yeah, we are, but I don't know why it's taking a lot. Let's just go with the zoo. Just go with the zoo.
I'll pay 5.
I'll pay 5. It's the zoo. I feel like we should lure this guy away from the woman inside the zoo. I'll pay for all of us to get in.
Oh,
I've
yeah.
I've got plenty of gold. Okay. Can we just see if they're, like, we don't know if they're, like, they're together or not, they can just friends.
They two appear to be, like, at least together for right now, and leaving the zoo, not going in.
Oh.
If you'd like to confront them.
She might be his next victim, if he's, like,
evil.
He's evil?
I mean,
evil?
She senses evil. Your paladin does
sense
evil, yes.
And I took
a little bit of money. He, like,
straight
is murdering children in the woods. Sort of shit.
Let's
trace
him.
Can we stop them
right now as they come out if you like and talk to them, but you need to do it now before you run out of time, so this discussion can't last very long or they're going to walk away.
Let's have the boar distract the woman.
I want to go in the zoo.
And we'll find someone else.
The boar.
I look out of character. I would like to gain some.
Okay.
XP is king.
Or start shit with guards.
Alright.
I mean, this body snatching thing to do it.
Alright, let's take the evil guy.
Just say it.
I'll be evil.
Alright, so you guys approach this couple?
Yes.
Alright, the four of you approach a man and a woman?
Fuck you.
Alright, let me send an air because it's soon. Figure it out. I'm out of here. I'm just talking to the guy.
Yeah, I go up
to the guy, well, the couple, but I look at the dude. And say, I know what you are. Can I do that?
You can do that with an intimidation check.
Yes. I want to try to intimidate.
Don't have intimidation. But you can
always try it. That'll be plus charisma. You can back her up if you want. You can assist an intimidation, or you can try your own after her.
Yeah.
Fuck it. Do it anyway. Roll them dice.
Yeah.
Maybe roll a 20.
All right. He sort of laughs and she, like, pushes your hand out of his face and keeps walking.
I come up behind her with
All right, you try to stand there with your arms crossed looking impressive, but he pulls his coat to the side and flashes a gun and doesn't look afraid of you at all.
I use throw anything, but Snatch is going to throw it.
Well, first you have to do a CMB to disarm to grab his gun.
Okay.
And then throw the gun would be the next, that would be your next turn. So would you like to roll for initiative with this young man?
Yeah.
All right, let's roll for initiative, everybody. That's all, includes everyone, because now the fight's going to begin. You guys might as well get involved.
The horse zoned out and so went to the shit again. What happened?
Erica approached the guy.
Okay.
They both failed their intimidation test.
Oh,
horrible.
Shit.
She's got a three.
Now she's about to try to reach for his gun, so we have to roll to see who gets to go first.
Oh, shit. Okay, I run back in the park.
I got a 15 initiative, so if you beat 15, you can go before the guy.
Five.
I got a two. I got a two.
All right, so we're going to tie, you and I, Karim. Because you guys are very new at this, I don't want to fuck with you. I'll just let you guys win because you're the player. So that'll be you, Karim. So Karim gets to go first, and then this guy, and then everybody else after the guy and the girl. So Karim, you can do whatever you want to defuse the situation or to continue it. It's your choice right now.
Is this lady reacting at all, or is she like still next to him?
She's still next to him, and she looked panicked. He looks like he's not intimidated, reaching for his gun. She looks afraid, but he does not.
I think I'm going to try to get this lady out of the way and let them go at this guy.
Classic paladin.
Yeah. I'm trying to go by what my character is.
So how would you like to do that? Are you trying to like tackle her and get out of the way, or are you trying to convince her to come with you, or?
Try to convince her.
All right, so that's a diplomacy roll.
I've got plus four. I'm convincing her. Man, you don't know. I don't believe you know this man. We're gonna help you. Four plus four, eight. I got eight.
All right, not very convincing. She clutches tighter to the man she's with. She doesn't know you. She thinks you guys are trying to mug her or something. She's panicking. He pulls out his gun and pulls it on the person that was threatening him. So that's you, Eriku. I rolled a natural 20. So he pulls it. He points it at your head and fires.
What?
Doing 13 damage.
-1.
All right, so you're unconscious. You're not dead. In the game of D&D, you're only dead. What's your constitution total?
20.
So whenever you get to -20, you die. Right now you're at -1. So you are unconscious.
For the healing thing.
Yeah. So right now, Eriku got shot and is unconscious on the ground, bleeding. Probably not bleeding out very fast. The bullet probably just grazed her just enough, but she's down on the ground.
Yeah, I'm definitely not going to charge that dude. I've got a longbow. I'm going to draw that shit out and fire him.
Yeah, fuck this guy.
All right, roll it.
I mean, I can't just...
He just shot her
red
unconscious.
I know things
are
shaky, but he just shot my homie in the fucking head. She made me breakfast.
It's true. Fast friends.
Yeah, all gas. Bonded by breakfast. Plus fucking Gorm needs a kill. I need to draw blood.
You're probably just excited to be in a fight.
Here we go. Longbow. It's at the guy. I don't even really have a general fucking guy. I got a 12. And that would be plus 3, so I got a 15.
Alright, so I get a reflex save on that because it's just barely a hit. I rolled high enough that I'll take half damage, but you will hit me. So roll the damage and I'll take half of it.
Six
damage?
Yeah, not quite as much as the bullet to the brain, but... Is it my
turn? Now it's Bekefo.
Okay, so I am communicating to Tiki Talker and I'm a boar thing, and I'm focusing my boar in on the woman. We need to get her the fuck out of here. So the boar has dexterity of 12. Can I just like run at her and be like, I'm gonna eat your soul or something and scare her? Can I try to scare her away?
If you want to try and scare her, that's an intimidation check.
Yeah. I don't have intimidation, but I'm rolling anyways.
Maybe plus charisma. So yeah.
I got 13.
All right, so above average intimidating, but not intimidating enough to, it's enough to scare her, but not enough to make her flee. So she is like, she does look more afraid as you run towards her and you speak in common, which is strange for a boar. Definitely frightening. Her boyfriend just shot a guy. There's a whole lot of commotion going on, but it's not enough to scare her away. Eriku, you're unconscious, so you cannot do anything, unfortunately. Karim.
I'm going to heal Erica. Well, I have 3 in heal. +3.
A heal check works better if you have a heal kit, which you don't. But if you roll really high, it might help. Otherwise, it'll just stabilize her, so that'll stop her from bleeding out. You might be able to, like, stop her bleeding if you have cloth to wrap around her wounds or something like that.
Okay, that's tough to heal her, though.
I got a 6.
All right, you rush over to Eriku, and you try to patch of your wounds, but you're not doing a very good job. You never dealt with gunshot wounds before. This is all very overwhelming for you. You're just trying the best you can. You're ripping your own sleeves off now. You're ruining your own outfit to aid your friends. Now your outfit is ruined until you buy a new one to repair it, but you've like tried tearing your own cloth to patch the wounds. It's still bleeding. You can't seem to stop the bleeding.
Darn it,
blood bath.
All right, she panics. Now it goes back to it's back to my guy with the gun, who points the gun at Aerog and rolls an intimidation check. All right, so I only rolled a 12 intimidation as he points the gun at you, Aerog, and says, "You and your hoodlums, back up, or I'm gonna call the guards."
Are we just running?
Yeah, let's just pick up Eriku.
Grab me.
And maybe go check out that. I know of this druid.
You've already said way more than you can say in 6 seconds, so.
I'm sorry.
That's
alright. I got to the woods, Todd!
You probably just yell, "To the woods, to the woods," and then Aerog can take whatever he likes.
Hit him,
yeah. I mean, you can still try to hit him. He's holding a gun in your face, but you could easily, like, disarm him or punch him, tackle him, whatever you want to do. Those are all options. Yeah, he's pointing the gun right at your face. He's no more than 5 feet away from you, so point-blank range.
Right into my face.
But it's your turn, so you can, you know, he can't shoot yet.
I'm going to try to disarm him.
All right, so roll a CMB versus his CMD.
12 plus 4, 16.
Alright, he has weak wrist, and you knock the gun out of his hand onto the ground.
Yeah.
He drops his pistol. That's the end of your turn. You can still move if you want, which means you could also grab the gun. And you can still do a swift, which is like talk or do something that doesn't require a standard, which is usually an attack or a move.
I'm going to go for the gun. I'm going to try to grab the gun.
Alright, so for your move, you try to grab the gun. Roll me a sleight of hand to try and snatch the gun. Or a dexterity, if your dexterity modifier is higher, but they're the same or... Or sleight of hand's higher.
10, 12.
You come close, but it's too near his foot, and he sort of like kicks at it, so you try to grab it, you don't quite grab it. It's on the it's in the ground. He doesn't grab it either, so it's on the ground in front of both of you. It is now the boar's turn.
The Kepo sees the gun on the ground and runs the fuck up and picks it up in boar mouth and just runs past him.
Alright. I'm gonna allow you to grab it in your boar mouth and just run past him. You might get an attack of opportunity because you're running past an enemy, but I'm gonna roll and see if it happens. I rolled a 10 versus your AC.
Her AC is plus 6.
So that'd be 16, because the base is always 10. So 16, so you're good. He misses the boar. The boar runs away with the gun.
Nice.
Iriku's still unconscious, so it's back to Karim.
I was just going to try to attempt again to heal Erica.
You can still roll another skill check to try and stop the bleeding.
Yeah, 13.
All right, a little better. The bleeding has slowed. You're now missing both sleeves, we'll say. Your biceps are now exposed because of this, but you've used that cloth to plug the wound in Iriku's head. I only rolled a 13 CMB versus your boar's CMD. The boar's CMD is 14, so I fail by just one. So the boar escapes. All right, so he lunges towards the boar and tries to grab it. He misses the boar, so now he's prone.
All right.
The boar is probably 30 feet away, and so is he at this point because he chased after it. Iriku's still unconscious, but the bleeding has slowed some. Karim, do you stay and tend to Iriku's wounds?
I'm going to try one more time.
All right, roll it.
Okay.
All right, so yeah, you're doing about the same. And then it was Aerog.
Yeah, he's on the ground now?
Yep.
Can't give for a reason. I'm gonna stomp his head and try to
get
him
it.
All right, attack him. Roll versus his AC.
Got a 15 on my dice.
Plus BAB plus strength if it's a melee attack, or BAB plus dex if it's a ranged attack.
Plus 4. Melee.
All right, so you run up and attack him with what weapon?
My foot. I'm gonna stomp him in the head.
All right, so you run up and attack him with your foot. And that is gonna be a hit. So you stomp on him, so roll that natural attack damage, which if you're medium, it is 1d6 plus strength.
That is 2 plus 3, 5. 5 damage to the dome.
Yeah, 5 non-lethal damage, so, you know, it hurts him, but, you know, that wouldn't kill him, probably, unless you keep... If you overdo it, it might, but otherwise, you know, it's pretty safe. You didn't go for any veins. You stomp on his head. He's still not unconscious, but he's down the ground. You're stepping on him. Bora, you're probably about 5 feet away. You can continue running away, or you can turn back towards them, or whatever you like.
I am going to turn back towards them. Can I try to give Aerog the gun?
Give me maybe a dexterity to try and like toss it to him or hand it to him.
7.
All right, so you run up and you're like waving it at Aerog, but he's too busy paying attention to stomping the guy. We'll say it's still in your mouth, but you haven't got his attention. You haven't been able to hand it to him yet. But you're nearby trying to get his attention. And then we're back to Karim.
Help!
All you know is he's bloody now, and his date's like screaming nearby about 30 feet away. You guys have sort of like run away from her.
I forgot about her.
So the two of you, Iriku and Karim, are near the woman still who's screaming. And Aerog and Bekefu and the boar body are about 30 feet away chasing after the guy and having the gun. So you guys are separated by about 30 feet, but you're over there by Iriku, who's still bleeding some, but you've managed to stop it or slow it down, you think, but not heal her or bring her back to consciousness. You can diplomacy the lady if you want. She's near you guys, and she's not really involved in the fight. She's just kind of freaking out.
I want to attempt to calm this lady down, because she's making me not be able to heal Erica like I could. She's making me nervous.
All right, so roll me diplomacy to calm lady down, and then tell me what you say.
I hate my rolls tonight. 10. All
right, so extremely average. Like, a 10 is, like, just... It's not bad, but it's not good either. This is extremely average. You're trying to like comfort this lady, but you're doing like the bad cop version, like they're or the average cop version of like trying to comfort someone, or it's not coming across really well. Like your friends are still kind of technically mugging your boyfriend, so you're like, just calm down, everything's fine. But your friends are still mugging your boyfriend, so it's not really coming across that well. But you are trying, and we got to give it to the paladin for trying. Some paladins are all about. You're trying to calm the lady down. It's just not succeeding. The guy who was going after the gun is now on the ground being stomped on. He's going to pull a dagger and try to swipe at Aerog, who was stomping on him. I only got a 14 versus your AC, Aerog.
16,
yeah, that's a miss. So he swipes at you and misses by about 2 inches. Then it's your turn. The boar is pretty obnoxious. I'm sure you noticed the boar is like squeaking at you with a gun in its mouth. If you want to grab it, you can try.
Yeah, dude, is a big concern of mine, though. I'm going to try to get the gun from the boar. Myself a leg up, I guess.
Right, yeah, so roll dexterity for your move to try and snatch the gun out of the boar's mouth.
I have points in hand on the animal, does that help?
No, only if you were trying to calm the boar down. You can roll that before you grab the gun if you like, but...
19!
That's good enough. No matter what you add to that, it's going to be fine. So you grab the gun out of the boar's mouth. That's your move for this turn, though. You still have a swift or a standard, so you can still attack or do something that doesn't require an attack or a move.
Can I just point the gun at him?
Yeah, that's an intimidate if you want.
Yeah, I would like to intimidate him.
All right, you point the gun at him and intimidate him. Roll intimidate.
9 plus 4 intimidation.
So 13, slightly above average, but not enough to stop him from, like, holding his knife at you. He looks nervous, but he doesn't look like he's, like, willing to give up the fight yet. He's still yelling for the guards, so he's still, like, yelling out for help.
Okay,
Bekefo.
So I start having giant war flashbacks in my dwarf multidimensional brain right now, and I just feel something crazy on this lady, and I'm gonna try to rip her fucking throat out. Like, I'm just like, she's screaming.
So you go 30 feet back to the lady. You don't take care of the guy. You go 30 feet back and take care of the lady.
Okay, well then I go on the guy. I am PSDing on someone right now. So like, I go towards the guy who's so close to me. I just try to rip out his throat.
All right, roll an attack on the guy.
Okay.
You will use your BAB and your strength. You're just using the boar's attack. So you use his weapon, tusks or claws, whichever one you're using. But roll for your BAB plus strength.
Damn it, that's fucking great.
The boar has an attack.
Well, you don't roll for the boar. She rolls for herself. Because she's not the boar. The boar, she only uses those numbers when the boar is himself. Right now, she's controlling the boar. So she uses her BAB and her strength. It's her spirit controlling the boar. She still uses his weapon because she controls his weapon. But it's her BAB and her strength.
Gotcha, okay.
So that is too low. So you try to bite at the guy but miss. Iriku's still unconscious. Karim is trying to comfort a lady. You continue trying to comfort the lady, or what do you got?
Can I use my heavy crossbow?
Yeah, you can pull your heavy crossbow and turn around and face the other way and shoot.
These numbers come out like, well, she has dexterity, but no bonus.
So 9 plus 0, and her BAB is what? Oh, it's probably still also a 0, because your BAB is a lot based on dex also, I think, so.
Plus 1 on here. It's totally 10.
Oh yeah, so yeah, it's a miss. So you fire a crossbow bolt and miss your target.
Oh, man.
Now back to the guy with the knife. He's going to swipe again at Aerog.
My rolls are terrible.
This time I got a 20, not natural, versus your AC. So that's a hit. So that's 5 damage to you, Aerog, as he cuts you with his knife. Probably gashes you right in your belly.
I'm gonna shoot him with the gun that I have pointed at him.
Alright, so you can use the gun, but because you're not a gunslinger, you take a minus four with it, so you can roll a BAB plus dex minus four.
15 plus three.
Minus four is a 14, but it's versus touch. But it is versus touch AC because it's a gun, so it's still a hit.
Nice.
Not a good hit, but you still, like, you know, it's not like right where you're aiming. You, like, graze him, but it's going to do some damage. You could roll a D6.
Five damage.
He is unconscious, just barely.
Whoa.
As he falls unconscious, three guards approach.
Okay.
All right, so you're holding a gun. There's an unconscious guy. There were shots fired. There's a lady screaming. You got a wild boar over here. There's three guards approaching, and they're about to start questioning you guys.
Can we know how far away the guards are from us?
You may. The guards are about 60 feet away. You see them coming, though. And they're in a hurry.
How far away am I from the lady?
You're about 30 feet away from the lady.
Okay.
Murphy's dead almost.
Can we? All right.
And they're closer to the lady than they are to you guys.
You guys almost
unconscious. All right, let's get the fuck out of here.
Said unconscious, but doesn't matter.
I'm like, let's retreat to the woods.
But if that was unconscious, we can't, like, run on top of
it. We cannot. It is not time for that. It
yeah,
we
not. Grab me. I run up on Eriku and just put my hooves on her and be like, fuck a body, my friend is dying!
Alright, so you guys want to flee with Eriku's body?
Yeah.
Throw me like a sack of potatoes.
Alright, who wants to try to carry Eriku?
To the woods! Yeah, I have a 17 strength.
Alright, how much do you weigh, Eriku? I know it's a personal question.
116.
So a 17 strength is enough to carry that just barely. So that's your normal carrying weight. So we'll assume you're still carrying stuff on you, but you're able to do that. You're not able to run, but you're able to move at normal speed. So you guys head into the forest away from the guards. Let's see if you guys are able to pull it off.
Thank God.
I rolled low enough that you guys lose the guards. They see you guys run to the woods, but they give up following you, and they stop to question the lady. So you guys might see her talking to the guards, talking to the lady as you guys head into the forest hiding. So you guys are now hiding in the forest. You know the witnesses in your recent crimes are being interviewed. So you guys have ducked out in the Donks Forest. A very large forest with magnificent trees. Largest cluster in this district.
Flits and tinders and whatnot. I'm going to fucking make a fire.
All right, and by the way, you all get 200 experience points.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. What do we do with that?
Attempt again to heal
Erica? Yeah,
you may. You can roll with your heal skill.
What? Four!
Alright, you guys flee into the woods. You can tell that your friend Karim is having trouble stopping the bleeding on your friend Eriku. She has shoved some cloth in there, but the blood from the gunshot wound seems to continue to pour. The cloth that she tore off of her own clothing is now, like, soiled with blood, like, wet with blood.
Can I use my spells as the boar?
You may, as long as they might require a semantic and verbal component, so as long as you can wiggle your nose and talk, you may.
Yeah, I have one called Stabilize.
That will stop the bleeding, so that would prevent her from bleeding anymore.
I have heal! I'm gonna roll a heal, my friend, Adam.
Is it a heal spell or a heal skill?
A heal. Well, my skill is plus four.
Okay, you can roll a skill. That's what Karim's been doing. You can roll that as well. Without a heal kit, that will not improve her situation, though. It only stabilizes it. The most you can do with a heal check is stabilize someone, unless you roll a natural 20 or have a heal kit.
So if I use my spell, it'll just do it anyway? Stabilize!
Stabilize will put her to zero HP, and okay, will stop her from bleeding.
Heal one will give her stuff back?
Only if you roll a natural 20 or have a heal kit, which I don't think you have a heal kit. It costs a bunch of money.
Go for this one?
Yeah. Is that a question? You're trying to stabilize?
No. You should stabilize me.
Yeah, stabilize.
If you stabilize, that's a spell. You don't have to roll anything. You just lay your hand, you lay your pig paws on or wiggle your nose and say some magic words. And it seems like her wounds have stabilized, but she still needs to heal. And if you guys have any potions or magic to heal her, that means she needs to rest overnight and maybe regain, you know, like, just heal. It's going to take some time.
We're laying low in the woods. We're like bandited it out. Let's just we got you stabilized.
I got fucking shot.
Let's let her rest.
Alright. So after the guards finish their interview with the lady, they come start heading towards the woods to look for you guys. So roll me a stealth check to try and hide in the woods and not be found by the guards.
Am I rolling this as well?
You're still unconscious, you don't have to. We'll let them roll cell checks, and hopefully they use that to hide you as well. So they assume you guys, like, all hide under leaves or behind a log or something.
I rolled a two!
Alright. Big orc guy, not very stealthy.
No.
Probably like burping and farting, making noises and stuff.
I was trying to make a fire. I stepped on its wake or some shit.
Yeah. Clumsy. So you other guys can roll, but Eric's going to give you guys away, but I still like to know how everybody's doing this and to set a scene, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Who is now seen by the guards?
Yeah. Who blew the cover? I mean, it's probably Aerog. I think we know, but...
11-4. We kind of all did.
Yeah, no one did great. The boar was the best of all of you, but definitely Karam and Aerog drew the attention of the guards who were looking for the suspects in this recent gang attack near the zoo. So you do see guards, the same three guards from earlier, like heading the woods your direction looking for you. Eriku is still passed out. At this point in time, it's only maybe been 3-4 hours. So Eriku, if you want to roll a d4...
Oh, I got 2.
All right, you healed 2 HP in these 4 hours, so you're now conscious, but barely. You're still wounded pretty bad, but you got 2 hit points, so you're awake. You wake up as the guards are running into the woods.
Okay, I can speak, though?
You can speak, you're conscious, you can move around, you're just very low HP.
In my weakened skin state, I'm like, I throw up my gang sign.
Alright, you throw up some gang signs. I'm gonna roll percentage chance on a gang sign. I rolled high enough that there's some slime boys in the area. They're gonna run some interference for you. So as the cops are heading this way, some slime boys drop down the trees and, like, divert their attention. All three of them run off, and that's gonna buy you at least 3 minutes. So you bought a distraction for 3 minutes.
On the offensive, you have the slime boys here now.
Yeah, can they help us fight?
Well, right now they're just distracting the cops. They're probably low-level slime boys. They're basically probably just running distraction. They don't want to get arrested. They're not going to attack a cop or anything. But they heard, they saw your sign, and they, like, pulled the diversion for you.
Continue running.
All right, so you get up with the rest of your group, and you guys run deeper into the Donk's Forest.
Yes.
I want to find out what's up with this. Can I try to find this druid place that you were talking about?
That'd be knowledge local or knowledge geography.
I want to use my knowledge geography +1. Not nature. Don't use nature check.
Your nature check might give you some clues as well, but it would give you different kinds of clues. Nature would tell you things about the trees and the foliage in this area and the type of animals that live around here and what berries are safe to eat.
+1, 17.
Alright, so you will know that the druids do spend a lot of time in this forest, comforting the animals, and at the zoo. Most of them live west in here in Woodlawn, where your rock used to reside, amid a vast plain of tall grass and huts.
Can we run in that direction,
you
guys?
You can.
Can we run to the druids?
Follow her.
Alright, so you tell everyone to run west.
Run west, this is your domain.
Follow you. Does anyone know how to get west from here? Does someone roll a survival check to know how to go west?
I have no direction,
and I can discern which way is north.
Alright, you're a Desnan? When the stars are out, you're disoriented, but I think you guys can still figure out west if you need to. But Kefu's pretty familiar with this area, so she's able to lead you guys west out of the forest, into the plains.
Can I look for the huts? Roll.
That's a perception check.
+4.
Alright, that's decent. You're able to see the, like, tops of, like, 60 or 70 huts poking out above the grass throughout the plains here.
Guys, I think if we go to this druid place, I can get us, like, I think I might know some peeps and we can, like, rest the fuck up. I'm fucking old as fuck. I'm like a god to people.
Well, we don't have any other options other than just running. So
yeah,
let's go.
Erica's still...
Yeah, she's some druid healing magic!
You guys want to go try to find a witch doctor and hide out in a witch doctor hut?
Yeah, yes. Please. Let's do that.
All right, you guys run towards the nearest available hut. You guys want to bang on the door or crawl in the window or what? Bekefo bangs her head on the door.
Bekefo Det,
the door is cracked open like someone peeks out. It's only open a couple of inches and they sort of squeal at you. Do you speak Sylvan?
Yes, I do.
All right, they squeal at you in the boar language. They must think you're a normal boar. And they squeal at you and they say, "What do you want, hog?"
I'm the Kefo Det. This is TikTok and I inhabit. You know who I be. Out here. Listen right now. In Sylvan.
So you speak like a pig. This guy says he's never heard that name before. As an animal of the forest, as a boar, he will welcome you into his home. I cannot be responsible for your human friends.
Take me to your head.
That's a diplomacy check.
Okay. Ooh!
Slams the door in your face. You know you need to hide somewhere. Even if it's just lay down in the grass and hope they don't find you, you know, like, you gotta hide soon.
Same hut. I'm gonna bang on the door again and try try to intimidate him through the door.
Alright, roll intimidate check.
Seven. No. Well, I did have a plus four, but that's, I mean,
this guy.
Average intimidation.
Yeah. So you bang on the door and he tells you guys to go away.
Can we walk up to the next hut?
Yeah, you can go to the next hut.
Okay, I've run to the next hut and bang my forehead on that door.
The door opens wide. All the way open. A smiling old woman with silver hair, short woman, smiles widely at you. She sort of bends down to your level, Boar. She gets right up in your face and says, "Hey, sweetie," and pulls some corn out of her pocket to feed you.
Oh, I eat this corn. Can I roll or something to know if I know her or not? I'll try that history one. See if me and this woman got history. It's 06. So
wait, yeah. And if she's around here, I could know her because my area.
Correct. You can also roll the same local or history check to see if you know her.
I have nothing in either of those, but I got a 6.
Yeah, let's tell you
about that. Alright, so far Eriku and the Boar know nothing about this lady at all.
Yeah, I'm going to have to talk to this lady with my diplomacy. Can I just have a moment of your time to talk to you? See, our friend over here is injured, and we really need a place to hunker down for a little bit until she gets better.
That's a diplomacy.
Plus 18.
18, Karam, that might work. I'm going to roll it. I roll that she's unsure. She will take in the Boar and your injured friend, but ask that the other two of you wait outside.
I'll take it.
All right, so the Boar and Eriku are welcomed into the druid's home.
Thanks for welcoming us into your home. And tune in next time for more of The Other Dungeon.
This episode of Long Distance Dungeons & Dragons Dinner Theater was sponsored by our fans and friends on Patreon. Donate today. Keep Long Distance Dungeons & Dragons Dinner Theater alive.